Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy with another in the series. Well, another machine has arrived. Went up to Kansas City, Missouri today and picked up a new dictation machine. And this is the dictaphone cameo model dictation machine. Now, this is a much later machine. This is probably from the 40s, late 40s, early 50s, because it utilizes plastic parts. Now, the machine came with its original hard case and a box of cylinders. I actually found it on Craigslist, and I contacted the guy about buying the cylinders. And he said, you know, by the way, I've got this dictation machine. And the machine was in its original hard case with the original speaking tube, the original cord, all the original hardware. And so I talked to him and wound up buying the machine and all the cylinders for $40. So I just thought I'd do a quick video. The machine actually works quite well. And so I brought it home. The belt was trashed. This machine's been sitting since probably the last time it was used, which was very likely in the 50s. It came in its original hard case, and the original hard case, it's been stored in a musty basement. And the hard case was in fairly poor condition. But when I opened it up, the machine itself is in actually quite good condition. And so I replaced the belt with a duct tape belt for now. And this is one of the original cylinders. These cylinders were covered with mold, just really, really eaten alive with mold. And it took about 12 passes on the shaver to shave it to get all the mold out of it. But the result was actually really encouraging. So we're going to do a quick test recording. So you raise the speaking tube off its cradle, the machine starts, the motor is running. Push the lever down to record. Let's do a quick test recording. Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, making a test recording on the dictaphone cameo model dictation machine. Just picked this machine up. It's been here about 2 hours now. Went up to Kansas City, Missouri, bought the machine, brought it home, took it apart, got all the parts broken loose, got it lubed and tuned, made a new belt out of duct tape, and the machine is up and running. So I just want to do a quick test recording on the cameo model dictaphone dictation machine, recording on one of the original black wax dictation cylinders, and just wanted to do a quick demonstration of the new dictation machine. It's actually working quite well. So as always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching. All right, so we stop the cylinder. Go back to the beginning of the recording, which is about there. It's really hard to see in this light. And here's the result. So as you see, and you know, it just emphasizes everything I say about buying junk machines. Don't overlook the junk. Now, I contacted this guy about buying the cylinders, and he just mentioned that he had a dictation machine. So when I looked at it, I thought, I've got nothing to lose. If nothing else, I could use it for parts. And then, like every other dictation machine, when I got it home, the thing works. All it takes is some oil and a few minutes. I mean, in less than an hour, this machine was up and running, including making the new belt. And so it's a pretty straightforward machine. Really, really simple. And this is all acoustic, of course. And as I keep saying, if you're looking for an inexpensive way to get into begin recording on cylinders, don't overlook the dictation machines. They're available. They're inexpensive. There is no collector's interest in these machines at all. Usually you can pick them up quite inexpensively, like I did with this one. So the 1910 dictaphone I picked up for $15. The 1925 dictaphone I picked up for $10. This machine with a box full of cylinders was $40. And like I said, I was going to buy just the cylinders until he mentioned the machine. And the machine's in really decent shape. It's been sitting in that case forever. This is one of the rub marks where the hard lid comes down and actually holds the machine in place. And so the machine has been in that case for, 50 years? Something like that. But a few minutes work, literally, a few minutes work. The machine's been here less than 2 hours. And the most difficult thing was making the belt. And even that only took 2 minutes. And I put a new duct tape belt on it, lubed it, tuned it, and the machine's up and running. So I just wanted to do a quick video just to demonstrate the new machine. Great little dictation machine, the Dictaphone Cameo model. And I have the matching shaver for it now. So in any case, I just wanted to do a quick video so you could see it. As a stress again, don't overlook the junk. And if you're looking to get into recording on cylinders, this is the cheapest way you're ever going to find to do it. Pennies on the dollar compared to an Edison cylinder phonograph. So as always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email. TheVictrolaGuy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.